अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर इंग्लिश, द वर्थ ऑफ अ फैब्रिक। सो हियर इज़ अ स्मॉल स्टोरी अबाउट द थिरुवल्लुवर। सो लेट्स सी हु इज ही, वॉज ही, एंड विल लिसन हिज स्टोरी। सो द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज वर्थ ऑफ अ फैब्रिक। सो आई विल रीड वन पैराग्राफ, देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू। Pay attention. Thiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet who lived more than 2000 years ago. Thirukkural is the book of his teachings. It is greatly loved and respected even today. So children, Thiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet. He was a poet of Tamil who lived more than 2000 years ago. This is a story about 2000 years ago. Thirukkural is the book of his teaching. He wrote a book named Thirukkural. It is greatly loved and respected even today. Today the people love his book and they greatly respect today and loved Thirukkural. Now next paragraph. Thiruvalluvar was a textile weaver. He wove beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People said that he never got angry, never used bad words, never shouted at anyone. So Thiruvalluvar was not only a Tamil saint poet, but he was a textile weaver also. He used to make clothes. He wove beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People used to say about him that he used never get angry, he used never give bad words and never shouted. He's a very calm person. In the same town, there lived a rich young man. He wasted most of his time roaming around with his friend, then often made fun of the other people. So there was a man in the same town where Thiruvalluvar lived. So he was very rich and young man. So he only roamed here and there with his friend and teased others and making fun of other people. Next para. I don't believe what people say about this Valluvar, said the young man one day. I'm sure I can make him angry. Come on, let's have fun today. So that young man heard about the Valluvar, that he was a very calm person. He never used to shout to others, he never get angry. So he thought that let's go and have fun. I will make angry to the Valluvar. So they all went to the Valluvar shop. Next para. So the arrogant young man approached the Thiruvalluvar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. How much does this whole fabric cost? He asked. 8 coins, the saint named the price. The young man unfolded the fabric and turned it to 2. What the price of this piece now? So that man and some of his friends went to the Valluvar shop and he just picked up one piece of fabric and he asked what was the price of it. Valluvar calmly said, 8 coins. Then that man folded into 2 that fabric and tore it in between and then asked, what is the half price of this? Four coins, the saint answered politely. After the tore the fabric, he asked it, what is the half price of it? The calmly, he didn't get angry at why you tore my cloth. Just he asked, this is told, asked or told him that it is 4 coin. The youth was taken aback. Why doesn't the man get angry? He thought. He then tore the half piece into half again. And now, 2 coins was the answer. Now it was the young man who became impatient and agitated. He tore the pieces into half again and again, saying, and now, what's the price now? So again he tore that half into more half. Then again he asked. The Valluvar said then, now it is 2 coins. Now that man think that, how is it become? He's not getting angry, though I have tore his beautiful fabric pieces into 2 and I'm tearing it again and again and make it into small piece. Then also he didn't get angry. Thiruvalluvar calmly went on reducing the price of half every time. At last, fabric was reduced to rags. So Thiruvalluvar said a quiet tone. Now this fabric has become worthless. I will not name any price of this rag. That man keep on tearing that piece of cloth into small pieces, and after it become a piece of rags. Nathi Luvarwar said that man calmly, "Now I will not charge anything of this rag because it is now worthless." The young man did not know what to say, but he was proud of his riches. So he offered to pay 8 coins to the saint for first time. Thiruvarivar smiled, but he refused to take the money. "Young man, now this fabric is of no use. It has become worthless. Why? Because no one will be able to wear it now." Now, then the young man was very proud of himself. He offered the 8 coins to the saint. But Thiruvarivar smiled and refused to take the money. And he said to the young man, "Now this fabric is no use. It has become worthless because no one is able to wear it now." Next paragraph. "Do you know the fabric was made in a day? Many people have toiled to make it. The farmer who grew cotton in his field worked hard for months through sun and rain. He picked cotton from each balls and gave it for spinning. Then someone else carded the cotton and spun it into long uniform thread. The thread were dyed carefully so that they took on these lovely colors. My wife and I wove the thread together, putting in beautiful design. We thought someday someone will wear this fabric." So children, after that, Thiruvarivar said to the man, "Do you know that this fabric is not made in a one day? It used to take long time to make one fabric, and many people are including it to make this one fabric." So they explain all that the farmer have to grow cotton in his field for many months and under the rain and the sun. Then after he picked the cotton of each balls and spinning it, after that he carded cotton and spun it into long uniform thread. The thread were dyed carefully so that they took on lovely colors. My wife and I wove the thread together. He said that I and my wife, we both wove the thread together, putting into beautiful design. And we thought that someday someone will wear our fabrics and will be happy to wear it. Then all our work would have been rewarded. When you destroyed the fabric, you destroyed all the love and labor that went into the making. Money cannot bring it back." So he told that when you tore our fabric, we feel very unhappy. We feel very sad that we thought that somebody someday will wear our fabric, and with that happiness, we will think that we will get rewarded. But you destroyed our love, which we make happy to us. Next para. "The softly spoken word touched the young man's heart. Now he was really ashamed of himself. Listening that soft spoken person words, that man got very touchy and very feel ashamed of himself. And do you know, Thiruvalluvar went on to say, I can weave another fabric like this, but our life is also made like this fabric. If you tear it apart with hasty, thoughtless actions, it will be destroyed and you will not get it back again." So children, after that he continued, keep on saying that our life is also like this fabric. If you just destroy without any hastiness, without any thoughtless, our life will become worthless. So last para, Thiruvalluvar words opened the young man's eyes. There and then he decided to give up his kindness and bad habits. That after that, hearing that words, he decided to leave all their stupidness and be a kind, polite to others. So children, this is the end of the lesson, The Worth of Fabric. I hope you understood. In the next video, I'll definitely give the exercise. Thank you.